Let's continue with our Honest Look series and take a look at what's going on in Norman, Oklahoma, and what happened in year two in the Brent Venables era, and maybe look ahead to year three in the Brent Venables era as the Sooners move into the SEC. Really quickly, though, make sure you subscribe to the On3 YouTube channel, Oklahoma Sooner fans. We have had y'all with us really since day one. Like, y'all are the day ones of this channel, to be honest, or the day one, at least, of this show, The Hard Count. We were doing this show on another channel in Waco, Texas, in a makeshift lobby. Y'all were dialed in. Y'all were subscribed. If you have not yet subscribed, no time like the present. We're headed one direction and want y'all a part of it, so we appreciate y'all in advance for that. So, looking back at year two for Brent Venables, here's how I see the score. Punchline culture, zero. Brent Venables, one. Because think about all the things that you were hearing on social media. You were hearing 6-7, he's not a good head coach. Good luck in the SEC. He's a defensive coach. They can't coach defense to save their life. They're allowing 30 points a game. Man, they were wrong for letting Lincoln Riley get out of there. They should have done everything in their power to keep him there. Brent Venables, he's never been a head coach. He's not a head coach. Maybe a decent DC, but he's not the guy. Look at him, 6-7. All of those things were being said about Brent Venables and about Oklahoma. Just after year one. Feels knee-jerk reaction to me a little bit, but that's what was being said. Now, you fast forward the clock a year later, double-digit win season, a lot of momentum, moving into the SEC. So again, punchline culture, zero. Brent Venables, one. Not a bad scoreboard. So for year two, I think the best thing you could say about year two, if you're an Oklahoma fan, probably internally within that locker room in Norman, is, hey, mission accomplished. And not mission accomplished in the sense that, hey, we checked every one of our goals off, because I'm sure they would have liked to win a Big 12 title, probably would have liked to make the college football playoff, compete in New Year's Six Bowl, all those things. But with that being said, like, what you needed to do in year two, if you're Brent Venables and if you're Oklahoma, I think you did. 10-win season. Momentum for the SEC, which you can take momentum on the field, and then what can you do? Funnel it onto the recruiting trail and lock up, at the time of us recording this at least, another top 10 class. So that's back-to-back now, two top 10 classes for Brent Venables. Punchline culture is not aging super well. Went from allowing 30 points a game to 23 points a game. Still probably not exactly where Brent Venables wants it to be. There were some games where there was more left to be desired. They were dinged up at times. Kind of the nature of the beast. But the defense took some really solid strides, which I think you have to be encouraged about in Norman. So there's progress made there, and I think there's a tremendous jumping off point for this new chapter of Oklahoma football in the SEC, but they're not settling. They're not saying, great, 10 wins, awesome. Let's rest on our laurels now. We'll kind of just kick them up and enjoy this. No, no, no. They're like, all right, that's a good next step, but we got some more steps we want to take. There's some real sense of urgency, I believe, still in Norman, Oklahoma. So how are they going to get to where they ultimately want to go, which I think is winning conference titles in the SEC? Yes, dare we say it, that's their goal, I believe. Compete for national titles in this expanded college football playoff, all that. There's some major hinge points for me as it pertains to how they get to those next stops on their goal list. And I think it's twofold. One, Jackson Arnold progressing and stepping into his role as now being the guy. Because you saw him in the Alamo Bowl, and a lot of people, again, punchline culture, running rampant and saying, well, look at all these turnovers. He's not the guy. He's not ready. No, 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 no. If you actually watched that football game, you saw a lot of flashes from Jackson Arnold. You saw him do some really good things. Saw him make an impressive, like, 60-yard bomb for a touchdown to Brennan Thompson. Saw him running left and having to twist his hips and throw back to the corner of the end zone. Like, you saw the magic there. You saw the juice that this guy possesses. But it's one thing to have a ton of ability. It's another to channel it and to play within the system and to get comfortable as the guy. Now, the great news for Sooner fans, you have the entire offseason where Jackson Arnold knows he's the guy. 15 practices to stack some bricks, entirety of fall camp before they hit go on the 2024 campaign. Like, you got some time now for him to get acclimated. And how he gets acclimated and how quickly he gets acclimated is going to, I think, dictate a lot of their success in 2024. Not novel analysis, just something we got to all agree on and get lined up on. Other part of this is the progress and the development of some of this young talent, especially on defense, because we said it earlier in this segment, man, like, they have not one but two top 10 classes currently in Norman. Both those top 10 classes are stacked with some defensive studs, man. You saw it this past year. Peyton Bowen, that's a dude. PJ Adebarare, that's a dude. David Stone coming in this 2024 class. I said, dude, like they got some guys now that are going to be able to contribute for you if they're able to be further developed or far enough along, rather, to make some noise their first year in Norman, David Stone specifically. But those guys that played last year, being able to build off of that and then elevate even from that is going to make them really dynamic. And the reason why I focus on the defensive side of the football, like Brent Venables, his reputation as a defensive coordinator speaks for itself. His resume speaks for itself. What he is a really good defensive coach. Now, he's a great head coach as well to this point in his career, but his recipe for success, his scheme defensively, like it's the recipe is complex now. Requires some very specific ingredients, some very high-end ingredients, a lot of really talented players, especially in that front seven that you're going to need. But I think you're a lot closer to having that based on what you had last year, what you got through the portal as well this past season, and how they progress, how they get more comfortable in that defense, to me, is going to dictate just how far they can go along with Jackson Arnold. The defense for Venables, if he has his guys, it is elite. But the trick with that is you really require some versatility. You got to have an edge defender that can rush the passer, but also can peel off and play the flats, can run with a running back on a swing route. Like, it takes kind of some freaky players to be able to do what Brent Venables is asking you to do defensively, but I think they're getting closer to that from what they have on this roster. So how they progress and how they develop, especially those young cats and those new cats they got via the portal, it's going to make a big difference. So for Oklahoma, check the box in year two, took punchline culture down, knocked it out cold from what they were saying year one. There's always going to be some buzz, always going to be something said about what you can't do, especially when you're a big brand like you have in Norman, Oklahoma. But I, for one, would be encouraged if I'm an Oklahoma fan. I'd be excited and anticipating what Jackson Arnold will do with a full offseason under his belt. And I'm excited to see what they do their first year in the SEC. Make sure you subscribe right here so you don't miss a minute of what we got going on. We love y'all. We appreciate y'all. We're going to keep this party rolling, and we will see y'all next time. Hey, y'all. Thanks so much for watching. Subscribe to the channel here to make sure you don't miss an episode of The Hard Count. Also, be sure to check out other videos on the On3 YouTube channel.